Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today is my second installment of the new makeup releases, Will I Buy It, Indie and Drugstore. So if you want to know what piques my interest, then just keep on watching. So my second Will I Buy It drugstore and indie. No, I say that wrong. And make new makeup releases. Will I Buy It drugstore and indie? Wow, that's a mouthful. But yeah, this is my second one. And before I start, this is not my idea. I didn't come up with this idea. The idea was actually to do it this way. It was created by Samantha March. I will leave her channel down below. She also created a community playlist where you can also find my video, but also the video of a lot of other creators. And I will leave that down in the description box as well. So go check that out. And yeah, let's get into the Will I Buy It, the makeup releases. Now, oh yeah, before I forget, if you like the look today, yes, don't freak out. I know it's a neutral look, but I still kind of like it. I did Get Ready With Me live last Sunday, and this is what I created because I'm filming this on Sunday and it goes up on Wednesday. So yeah, when you will see this, today is Wednesday, but I filmed it last Sunday, if that makes sense. So you are seeing me in the past. Wow. Let's go into the stuff that released. I hope I am sounding okay. I plugged in my microphone and they are about to have some kind of dart tournament here in the neighborhood. So I hope I can get this filmed before they begin. But yeah, let's get started. I have my tablet here. I have my notes here. I will scoot a little to the side like so. And yeah, so I can put up all the pictures here. Okay, so let's start with Catrice. They are launching their new pure pigment lip lacquer on their site. I am on Instagram and this is posted by Catrice US, so I am assuming it is on their American site. And I actually really like them, so I hope we have them in store in the Netherlands as well, because I'm actually really interested in in all of them, except I think the nude one, the brown one. That doesn't really speak to me, but I have to see it in store so I can swatch it. But yeah, I'm actually kind of interested. They also have another lipstick, that's this one, that's our new Matte Lover lipstick. They have a matte finish, but still feel light and creamy on the lips. I have some matte formulas from Catrice and I really like it. So I am kind of interested in the one, the lightest, what is it, pinkyish nude? I kind of like that one. So again, I will check in store, see if they have them, and probably check one out. They also came out with Precious Pigments. They are loose pigment shades and have endless possibilities. It says on Insta, tag us in an image with your most creative use of our pigments for a chance to win $100 Ulta gift card. So I am assuming they are on sold at Ulta. I cannot check the Ulta site. So I'm sorry, but I cannot. It says you don't belong with us. You are not in the US. Go away. So that is what they say. I haven't noticed them in store here, but then again, I haven't looked for them either. But they are pretty. Maybe the purple one. I am looking for red shimmer pressed pigment, so more of the bold color. So I don't think I will pick these up, but they look pretty. They are also launching a new foundation. Their HD Liquid Radiance Foundation comes along ultra light and moisturizing, perfect for hot summer days. They're a bit late with that. I haven't seen it in store yet. So I am assuming it is about to launch. I have the matte one. Oh no, the normal liquid coverage. I'm testing that one out and so far I really like it. So I'm anxious to try the Radiance version. I just wish they would expand their shade range because it is just atrocious. I don't know when it will launch in the US, because from what I understand, they launch it in Europe first because they are a German-based company and come to the US a little later. I don't know if I can pick it up in store. I will, then I will do a review on it and hope that you guys in the US can get it as well if you want to, of course. So that was Catrice. Next we are going to go to Essence. They have new lipsticks. This is from Essence Cosmetics, so this should be available in the US. I will check. But they are 12 new stunning shades with a super creamy texture and a velvet matte finish. They say our vegan velvet matte lipstick range will be in stores end of August. Let me see if I can see more. No. I think I have one of those here. Let me see. I have a velvet matte lipstick here. Velvet matte lipstick. So I have one here. And this one is actually going out of stores in where I live. If it's the same one, they're really, really nice and stay a long time. But I don't know why. But again, they were in the we are getting rid of them bin at the drugstore where I live. So I don't know if they are discontinued here in Europe, or it is just that my drugstore isn't that big and needs to make room for new stuff. I'm not sure. But if you can get your hands on them, they are really, really nice. Sorry about that. I think this is a bit better. But we were Essence lipstick. So again, if you can find them in store, check them out, because the formula is really, really nice. They are also bringing to the US 3 nail products. And they are a new nail care trio. The Beauty Nail Rituals, is what they are called. And you have a nail and cuticle peeling with pear fragrance, nail and cuticle mask with apricot fragrance, and a hydrating hand cream with blueberry fragrance. So if you are in those, well, if you like that kind of thing, you can check it out. Next up is from Essence Makeup. So this is a new launch in the EU, in Europe. This is their Believe in Magic Sparkling Body Mist. And it says, all it says is, do you believe in magic? Well, you're about to with our new sprays. I don't usually go for body mist sprays, but if you are in this kind of, if you like this kind of thing, go check it out when it's in store. I don't have a pricing for it yet, but no, it's not my thing. The last from Essence Makeup is, and I think I already saw this in store, is their Rainbow Highlight. And it says available now. I do like the brush that's on the picture though. But I don't know. It could be fun to use as inner corner highlight for different makeup looks. So maybe if I see it in store, I know I can swatch it. And if I like it, I will pick it up. But for now, if I pick it up, I will not use it as a face highlighter, but probably on my eyes as eyeshadow. I don't think so, but you, I don't know. Okay, next up is NYX. And NYX Cosmetics NL put out this picture of their new lippies, the matte suede lipsticks, the suede matte lip liner, and the lip tease lacquer. They are now available in the Netherlands. And I have prices here. The suede matte lipsticks are retailed for €9.40. The lip liner for €4.15, and the Tease lip lacquer for €8.35. I think they have been raved about, so if I can get my hands on one, I will probably try it. I don't know which one yet, but I will see. There are, I think Douglas sells NYX here in the Netherlands where I live, so I will check their site, and maybe the next time I'm in Alkmaar, they have a NYX section in Douglas, so I can see what they have there. But yeah, I'm kind of interested. So if I see them in store, I will probably get one or two. Next is from Trendmood is the sneak peek for the NYX Holiday 2018 collection. Looks interesting. I have no, I have a few pictures. I have no idea if it will come to store here. I don't know. For me, it's not that easy to get a hold of Nyx where I live. Yeah, I can get it via through the internet, but usually I don't like to do that unless I know what shades I like and that kind of thing. Or if it's really cheap, sometimes I will just gamble. But I don't know. I don't think I will get anything from their holiday line. But you, again, you never know. They also brought out this picture of their new Midnight Chaos lip glosses. Ultra pigmented lippies that come in 12 glistening tones. And I actually like some of them. Can I? Oh yeah, I can. Oh. I like the fact that there are weird colors in them. If I see the color, the first color Moonbeam, it looks a bit greenish. And then you have Pastel Comet, a bit bluish. I kind of like that. I kind of like different kinds of lips. Oh, I saw the it saw it on the dark skin tone. So it has a shift in it. Orange-green shift. Hmm. If I run across them, maybe I will pick one up. Because I actually, I'm quite intrigued by those. Is that everything or is it just a highlighter? No, they're a gloss. Yeah. What else do I have? That was it from NYX. Next up is Sleek and they are coming out with single eyeshadows. And I don't gravitate to single eyeshadows. I have to be totally honest. I do love the Sleek highlighting palette that I have. I like their liquid lip that I have. But I am not gravitating towards singles. So, no. I don't think I will pick them up. Unless it is a color that really, really speaks to me and is really unique for my collection, I probably will just pass over this one. Okay, next up we have Maybelline. And this is also from Trendmood and it is the Maybelline Soda Pop Eyeshadows. And I thought they had already brought this one out. It says online at Ulta Beauty. I don't know. I don't know if we have it in store here. I'm gonna pass over this. And why am I going to pass over this? Because there are a lot of neutral shades in this palette. And you know, for what Maybelline goes for in the Netherlands, I would rather pay some extra and get an indie brand palette that has a lot of shades and a lot of shades that I like. So no, I will pass over this one. The swatches look nice, but it is, yeah, you have your orange, you have a purple and a reddish, so I kind of like the bottom quad, I like that, but the rest, nah, it just no, I'm going to pass over this unless the reviews are raving. I see it in store and I get it on sale. But I don't think I will pick this one up. No. But again, if you like it, try that. Next up is Rimmel. They are coming out with a maxi blush in 4 shades. And it says lightweight powder with maximum pigment, for maximum impact. Available in 4 shades. Third base, wildcard, exposed and sweet cheeks. I have no idea when this will come to the Netherlands. And when they come to the Netherlands, first off, I want to know the price. Because Rimmel is also getting pretty expensive here for a drugstore brand. And I need to swatch the colors. So it's a maybe. It's a maybe. If you have these, please let me know how they perform. Because I am interested. And we also have from BH Cosmetics just launched their, let me see, what is this? Oh yeah, it's the latest addition to their glitter collection. They have 7 new shades, including Mermaid Mood, Spiced Pumpkin, Lit and Shamrock. I saw some swatches, I like them, but I'm not really into glitter. I would rather have pressed pigment. With maybe a bit of a, not a glitter, but a shine, a sparkle. So I think I'm going to pass over these, and also we have a German site where we can order, but it takes a little while for new products to get there. So I could order them from the US, but then I have shipping and taxes and all that nasty stuff. So I think I'm going to pass over this for now, at least. Next up, let's go into a revolution. We have from Makeup Revolution USA a new addition to their best-selling Reloaded family. This is the Velvet Rose palette. It features 15 shades packed with rich pigments. It retails for $7, £4 or €4.99. It says this one is sold at Ulta and also at Shop Revolution Beauty. I have one of their Reloaded palettes. It was an old one and it's actually kind of nice. I'm going to pass over this one because this is just, it doesn't speak to me. If you like these colors, you can, it's cheap. Check it out. You get pretty big pans and the quality is nice. The shadows are nice. So yeah, if you like it, go check it out. But I am going to pass over this. Okay, now we are getting to something I am excited about. Last week when I posted my Will I Buy It video, it was also the launch day of this, the Revolution X Emily collaboration. And now we see the shades. I saw her release video and oh my god, I cried with her. I'm getting goosebumps again. It was so nice to watch. She is so genuine and she was just, I am an emotional person, but I'm emotional on the inside, if that makes sense. And I get emotional again just thinking about how happy she was in that video and how happy she still is with this release. I picked up both. Yeah. And you may go like, but they are not really your colors. Well, actually, they kind of are. If I look at the palettes, I wanted to get the eyeshadow palette. When I saw the release video and I saw it on the site, I thought, yeah, I like this palette. Yes, you get some neutral shades, but you get some. It's not like half the palette are neutrals and one or two pops of color. I think she did a really good job. I saw the swatches. I haven't seen her four looks with it. It's on my watch list, so I'm probably going to watch this later today. But I really like it. For me, this is a nice fall palette. Yeah, maybe the colors are not as bright and as vibrant, but still, I think I'm going to have a lot of fun with this palette. So I'm waiting on it. When I have it, I will of course do multiple looks with this palette. And I was debating a little bit, shall I get the Needs palette as well? But I kind of do. The way she described this palette, I think it's going to be a nice palette for when I don't have a lot of time to play with my makeup. Fortunately, usually I have the luxury that I can take the time for that, but sometimes I don't or I don't want to. And I think that the little palette can be a nice addition. Yeah, it is neutrals with a few pops of color, but I think I like that. And this was just something that I really wanted to support her in because I love watching her. I think she is a very, very nice. Now I know I don't know her personally, but she comes across as so nice and so genuine, and I really want to support her. So that's why I picked up both. Again, the eyeshadow palette I was really into because I'm actually really liking those colors and the color scheme. And the face palette, the Needs palette, was more like, not really I needed, but more like I wanted to complete my collection, maybe something like that. So yeah, I got both, and let me know if you are interested, if you have ordered them, and yeah, let's get the conversation going down in the comment section. Last week I talked about something that I was actually kind of excited about. It was the skincare line from Revolution, and it launched last Friday, and I checked out the ingredients. I have a picture here from a few bottles that I have. The superfruit extract contains a fragrance. They added fragrance to that. The rest of the line doesn't, although I did find one that contained linalool, but I don't know which one that is. If I find it, I will put a picture up. So it could be that if you are sensitive to that, just check the ingredients list, because they have listed the ingredients on the site, so that's really nice. And I ordered some things, not all. It does remind me of The Ordinary. I have to be totally honest, when I saw it, when I scrolled through what kind of products they have, it really reminded me of The Ordinary. The Matrixyl, the Multipeptide Serum, the Loose HA, Hyaluronic Acid, the Niacinamide and Zinc, the Lactic Acid. It all reminded me a bit of The Ordinary. Now, I checked out the ingredients. They have similarities, they have differences. So it is personal preference as well. I am curious to see how the formulation is in these. And I did order the multi-peptide serum because my own buffet is running low. So I can switch it out, compare it a little bit and see how it does. I also ordered the cream. I'm really interested in that one actually. And I think I ordered this one, the EGF serum. I don't really know yet what that is, but The Ordinary doesn't have that one or something like it. So we will see. And the reason that I didn't order more is because I have full bottles from The Ordinary and I don't want to break into something or open a packaging when I have a similar product closed, if that makes sense. So yeah, if I like the formulation of it, I will order more. I thought about getting the hyaluronic loose, but I don't think that I need it now, maybe in winter time. I know how the HA from The Ordinary works, how it feels on my skin, so I will definitely try out some more products of this line to see how it functions, because I know a lot of people are a bit not really scared of The Ordinary, but hesitant to order from them. Sometimes you cannot get them. There is a lot of controversy at the moment with them pulling out of, what was it, Sephora, Beauty Bay, some. I don't know. I don't really know what's going on. If I order, I always order directly from the Deciem website itself. So I don't know why, but they are going into stores and then pulling out again. And I really don't know what's going on. So I know a lot of people are searching for an alternative, and I think this could be it. So go check it out on the site. I will put the link to their skincare page or something in the description box so you can check it out. But I'm actually kind of excited about that. So now we are going to go on to indie brands. Now there are a lot of indie brands out there, and I pick the indie brands that are affordable to me. The most expensive eyeshadow that I have is from Juvia's Place, so that is a little bit of my top tier. And yeah, I do have to say I ordered Juvia's Place on a discount, so you know, yeah, it is also a bit what piques my interest. What does the shipping cost? Because I don't mind paying 25 euros for a palette like the Slush palette, but if the shipping is really high, I will pass on it, if you get my meaning. So, and I just actually picked things that were of interest to me. And yeah, Root Cosmetics, let me see. They have, it says K-beauty at its finest. Shop or skincare now to update your skincare routine from a 7 to a clear 10. Which product is your favorite? So they have some skincare stuff here. I am going to pass. Yeah, I'm going to pass. I kind of am. the miracle toner maybe. I have an AHA BHA peel and I have the glycolic toner from The Ordinary. And I like the peel more than the toner, but I am not, no, I'm not really interested in this. So I'm skipping over that. They also had something else. Oh yeah, here it is. They also had a sculpting concealer, concealing, highlighting and contouring. It reminds me, if I read this, a little bit of the Revolution Conceal and Define. The shade range looks okay. Let me know what you think. I am kind of eyeing this product, but I'm not really sure. Let me know what you guys think. Have you tried stuff from Root Cosmetics? Let me know. I'm not really sure yet. What do we have? We have Juvia's Place is next, and Juvia's Place is coming out with loose highlighters. I have never used a loose highlighter. And to be totally honest, I am having trouble with pressed highlighters as it is. So I don't know. If I want to try a loose highlighter, I will probably try the cheapest one that I can find just to see if I can work with a loose highlighter, if that makes sense. So for now, it is a pass for me. Yeah. For now, it is a pass for me. Oh, it says that the highlighters will retail for $14 each. And you can use the Cult Beauty, the code Beauty Cult for some money off. That's what it says on Insta. Let me know what you think. The last but not least is 50/50 makeup again. When I filmed this, the day after they came out with this glitter eyeliners, they have three. Oh well, they have a green, they have a pink, and is that three? No, it's gold, pink, and silver. It looks a bit green on in the picture. So here is the swatch, and here you can see pink, and still the gold looks a bit greenish to me. And then you have the silver. I ordered the pink one, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, so when they had their pre-sale last week, I ordered a bunch of stuff. I do have a discount code for you guys. If you go to their site and use the code NIKKI10 at checkout, I will link it and leave it in the comment, and I will put it down below. You get 10% discount. It is not an affiliated code. It's just for you guys to get to save 10%. Go check them out. I haven't gotten my products yet, so I cannot do a review for you guys. When I get them, I will. And I also will give you my honest opinion about this. So, yeah. This was my Will I Buy It number 2. And I am glad that they haven't turned up the music outside again or yet, because they will. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you feel like I have missed something, leave it down in the comment section below. If you didn't like this video, give it a thumbs down. And hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so already. Don't forget the bell to get notified when I upload a new video. And I will see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.